Hey folks, welcome back to Let's Play Grand Theft Auto Vice City on the Mysterious JG. So, if you hadn't already figured it out, despite the whole, one does not waive accusations to a man like Diaz, despite the fact that he just kind of told us and we're a freaking psychopath murderer, but, the Colonel has hinted pretty strongly that Diaz is the one who messed up our drug deal. He does seem like a violent, incredibly unlikable guy who thinks he controls the drug business in Vice City. So as we do the rest of his quests or his missions, we'll really find out, I think, for sure whether he's the guy. And if not, maybe he helps us, or somehow, without him helping us directly, we find out by working for him who the guys are. And if he is the guy, oh, we're definitely killing him. We're gonna be going one way or the other on that pretty soon. But for now, as long as we got our golf outfit on, which is like the most fun one to play around with, I'm going to stop by ammunition, one of the nice ones here in this city, not this island. There's one real nearby. Actually, there's not that many ammunitions in the game, quite frankly. There's really only the two. So,
thanks, guys. That one rocks.
Let's try to keep on the. I like the rock station by and large. So if we can, what is that damage noise coming from? All right, whatever.
I hope I die before I get old. I'm sure I will, thanks to this life of success I lead.
I think it's supposed to be a joke that Laszlo is not leading a life of success. He's just like posing, but I'm not convinced of that. So if we park here, no damage to the vehicle, we can grab some stuff. Second Amendment gives us the right to wander in here and buy Uzis up the yin yang. Out of stock. Why is all this? I don't understand why all this is out of stock. Well. Okay, that's one approach, game. You could just. I haven't advanced the story far enough to buy those weapons. So, future games will. And again, I love Vice City. It's got a great setting. I love the soundtrack. There are a lot of little things that the Grand Theft Auto series started doing better after this. And one of them is you go to an ammunition, and you each one doesn't just sell one type of each weapon, like one shotgun. That's a police helicopter. I don't know if you can do vigilante missions on them. I think maybe, yeah, you can, I think. It's just, I don't think it has guns. It makes it really hard. You're flying around, then you gotta land, get out, shoot the guys. It sucks. But, later games, you go to an ammunition, like it'll sell two or three different models of pistol, and if some of them aren't unlocked yet because they want you to advance farther in the story, that one will be unlocked, not all pistols, because they will sell more than the one pistol. In this game, it's like this store sells the advanced weapons, the ammunition on the previous island sells the early game weapons. So if you come to that ammunition, you can't do anything there, pretty much. This helicopter may or may not be useful in this mission, but we definitely don't have enough ammo left for. Like, I'm hoping we're not forced to do a lot of shooting out of a car in this mission, because if so, I really should have gone and bought the wimpy one. The fastest boat. I thought this was a Cuban mission.
That's so pleased with yourselves now, huh?
Whoa, watch where you're waving at thing.
Yeah,
no more
jeez.
pigeon shit on my car, eh, Tommy?
Guess not.
Well, I mean, not permanently.
Damn right. Now listen, you know who owns the fastest boat on the East Coast?
Not offhand, no.
Me! And I want it to stay that way. Every smuggler from here to Caracas has one dream, a faster boat. Rumor has it the boatyard has just completed such a vessel for some Costa Rican dickhead. And Tommy, I want that boat. Ah, I thought I got you! Where'd you come from? Pinhead!
I think your pigeons are back.
Speaking of pigeons, aren't we being a bit of a pigeon for him? Well, whatever. So we want to steal the fastest boat. I feel like I'm abusing the presence of helicopters, but it no longer... Like, at this point, it's legitimate that you can buy that safe house where I keep getting this helicopter. Using the Sea Sparrow that we got from 90 Hidden Packages is more of a... Feels like maybe a bit of a cheat. Like, if you get all the advantages... Like, the game lets you do it, but, like, using all the advantages of the Hidden Packages... Feels like it's a bit cheap. But at this point in the story, like, no, I have access to a helicopter. So if this, I don't know if this helicopter will make a difference. If it allows me to sneak past, like, just land directly where the boat is and get past a lot of gunmen, then it's just good strategy at this point. But it's not like I shouldn't be able to do this normally. And it looks like it's gonna, yeah, oh yeah, I'm getting attacked. Like, okay. Okay, this isn't working. Because I'd forgotten what buttons do what. So that wasn't good. I'd basically completely forgotten how fighting guys works because I haven't had to do it in a while. So just purely because it's going to be a big pain in the butt to... Oh, can I... What is... I forget about this. What is this going to do? Take me straight back to the... I think this will just take me back to the mission start point. That's no good. I'm going to need... Yeah. So that's their version of later games. We'll just, like, plain old ask you if you want to start at the checkpoint. You would think... Sometimes I wish that after you finish a mission, there would be a scene where you talk to the person who gave you the mission. Because some of the mission bosses are actually likable characters. I like the idea of a conversation where Cortez thanks you for stealing that fucking tank for him. But anyway, no, that's no good, because we just lost way too much ammo for our weapons. There's no point not loading at that point, because it's... Even though they're free to get, the ammo for these weapons is going to be pretty important for us in these missions. So what I'll need to do now is stick with this... Oh, come on, game. This is not convenient. And my convenience is what matters. Yeah, okay, this is really annoying. But, you know, maybe being forced to do it in an actual car is for the best.
Hey, get away from
it's not the best car in history, but... Oh, I keep making that turn and coming up here. I like this song, but I'm trying to... There's a specific song on the V-Rock soundtrack I haven't heard. And this entire... Like, on-screen, off-screen, I haven't heard it. And I really enjoy it, and I'm waiting to hear it. I'm starting to wonder if either A, it's not actually on V-Rock, or B, like, somehow it was removed from the PS4 version of the game because they didn't have the rights anymore or something. I wouldn't think that would make sense, but... And it's not Yankee Rose. I actually heard that one off-screen. So even though it would be fun to hear on-screen, because I could... Well, never mind. I was going to act surprised, like I didn't recognize the song when it was being sung by David Lee Roth, but I guess I've kind of already blown that joke here. How are they getting lazy shooting Love Fist? Well... And I guess I don't know enough about, like, prostates as a sexual thing to know why... what would having a stone-cold prostate mean? Yeah, liver buster would be a reference to drinking and drugs. Chin stainer would be a reference to, we got all the hot bitches giving us blowjobs, yo. I understand that. I don't get the cold prostate thing, but... I'm sure it's filthy. Like, I have no doubt that it's filthy. Actually, now that I think about it, I can still take a helicopter if I want to. I would just, I'd have to use the one that I'd been stealing to get hidden packages. It's behind Diaz's mansion. But I think I'll use a car instead, just to, give you the normal feel of how this mission is done. As incredibly hilarious as it is, I think I will skip past the, I don't know if you get to save boats in this game either. Like later games, like Grand Theft Auto V, you can have all sorts of goofy-ass vehicles that are permanently yours, but this game you can certainly jack boats and use them. I don't know that you have a place where you can save them permanently. So I'm keeping it on... That's what you get for having the same car as me. Or Diaz, I guess. You can certainly get some good speed going. I don't know if the PS4 handles it any better, or it actually seems like it's pretty much copying exactly the PS2. I remember an online sort of former associate of mine complaining about a couple of things in this game, and one of the things he complained about was apparently, like, he was having a lot of problems with, particularly when you start moving at speed in a car, it's like details warp in after you're already crashed into shit before you can see what the hell's going on. So,
you know what this is? You pushed me.
Okay. So that's a pretty damn powerful handgun. And it might be useful to actually get the stuff that these guys drop. Well, there's the boat. And apparently I took too long because this drop disappeared. So I have 1-star wanted level, which I can wait out, but I don't want to get killed by guys. And the 150 armor can be pretty handy as far as this goes. That wasn't that many guards, but they almost took me out. So where is the switch that is going to lower this boat? Not something that you want to, like, try to figure out while hoping that they're, you know, it's like you need to kill the guards first. You can't... Oh. You guys really fucked me over there because by attacking me... Oh, never mind. I had to deal with them anyway because they were in front of this thing. That's got me to 2 stars, which means I can't just wait it out and not have the cops after me. The cops will be after me as I try to escape on this boat. And never mind, all those new guys popping up is also going to be an issue. How did only one of you have a... Never mind, well, I just got a new gun from that guy, but maybe I should have stuck with the old one? Oh, it's got a lot of ammo. None of those other guys dropped guns. Oh, never mind. We got an additional wanted level just by stealing it. Because the whole point of this mission is it's super fast, and we have to try to avoid the cops who will be after us. Like, they don't really want us having an easy trip back. This thing is fast, though. And actually, the main trouble with these boats is sometimes navigating them in for the very last part of the trip. Because there's going to be a little port we're going to have... Oh, never mind. They make it easy. It's huge. You're not parking, really, in a... okay, never mind. That was super easy. Hmm. Now I'm mildly annoyed about having to go save my game. I mean, I don't have to, but it's a good idea.
If he dies, I take over.
So this is the Sea Sparrow that appears because I have 80 packages. And it will allow me to get to Ocean Heights Hotel and save the game. And it actually has a gun, I think. Yeah, it's got a machine gun. It doesn't have missiles like the Hunter has. And you can't, of course, do... about to say, so it would be good for vigilante missions, but no, you can't do vigilante missions, isn't it? It's not a... excuse me, a law enforcement vehicle, so never mind. Aye, aye, aye. So with any luck at all, I will not destroy the helicopter on the way down, and it will still be here when we... after we've saved our game, we can do another Diaz mission in this video. I think we got about 10 minutes or so left. Probably a little more than 10 minutes. Yeah, and I tell you, once you finish the Diaz missions, if you ever find yourself in this part of town, and this is the most convenient place to go get your weapon drops and save, it feels weird to come. It doesn't feel weird to me now, because I've been coming here specifically because of all the weapon drops. I'm playing through on original hardware. I didn't have a FAQ to go through and get all the hidden packages, so I was just playing through the story, getting hidden packages as they came. I think I'd probably beaten most of the story before I bothered to find a guide for the hidden packages. And as a result, I would save it whichever one was nearby, and I wouldn't use this one much at all because it didn't have garages. But normally, when you come all the way back here, you're like, oh yeah, I remember that hotel from the beginning of the game. Yeah, I've got nostalgia for it now. And my helicopter's still here, and a cop car has been forced to pull around it. But it is not considered stolen because I parked it here, even though I guess technically I stole it from Diaz, but... I'm not too worried about that, guys. A fun song, but still not hearing the one that I've been waiting for. Oh, it's ending. Never mind, it's just starting. So this is one of those fun 80s songs. Like, it doesn't feel like a hard rock song. Like, I get confused about what's considered new wave and what's not, but I like almost all the music in this game. That is not a safe way to exit a helicopter. Just go running up full speed right next to the tail rotor. What?
I am the boss's right-hand man.
Supply and demand.
Eject, plastic crap! You're doing this to me? Who do you think you are, you piece of plastic shit? Ah! Oh. Ah! Oh. Bro, you! It is my favorite El Burro movie. It's tight. What else can I do?
It's probably not plugged in.
What? Damn. No matter. I can buy 100 more.
Well, 1,000 more, really.
Now, Tommy. Each month, a freelancer sails into Vice City and moors his yacht. He sells his cargo to the first boat.
He waves around loaded guns a lot. Oh, jeez.
And beat all the other shitheads to
He's
it.
Scratching his crotch with the gun that just here. Fired. That has to be so okay. Hot. Yeah, well. We haven't had a Versetti commentary post getting a mission brief for a while. But anyway, so we stole the boat. Now we're going to use it to steal some drugs. Pretty cool. See how much time I got left. We might be in mid-mission. Might have some mid-mission shopping here. Might have a mid-mission break here. Yeah, it's a little too early for me to just call it a video. So maybe we'll get this done real fast. I don't know. But yeah, he fires off a gun. The barrel is going to be hot, right? He's fucking... oh, never mind. I get the humor of it. Diaz is a comical character, but it's difficult to imagine how this such a goofy guy ever got to be in charge of like a criminal empire. Like, you can kind of believe that Colonel Cortez, he's got the kind of the grace to handle business negotiations, but the ruthlessness to do what you need to do for a criminal organization. And Avery Carrington the same. Diaz, it just seems like he would have been murdered by now by somebody. We haven't seen Lance Vance in a long ass time. Is he going to be? Oh, yep.
Let me guess.
I didn't know that he was going to be here.
I could use a guardian angel.
I'm just saying, you Setsuna. Need to let me in there, my man. Now, you can feed me all this lonely tough guy crap. But I know one day I'm going to save your ass, and you're probably going to want to kiss me.
Wacko.
Well, I mean, if you shave first. But yeah, guardian angel Setsuna. Somebody complimented me on throwing in a, oh, here we go, never mind. So am I piloting the boat, or is he? I think this is one of the ones that I failed a bunch of times, too.
I mean, we know it was Diaz busted our deal, so
do we know that officially?
The more we learn now, the less we have to learn when we take this town over. I like your style, man. Real friends.
Yeah, I think he's the gunner, and we're Popeye the Sailor Man. Lance Vance dance involves shooting machine gun. As Tommy ever said, he tries desperately to kill us both. Yeah, the boats I'm nowhere near as good as I am the helicopters, because they just bounce around like a crazy. I don't understand how the computers players are so good with them, actually. I already feel like we've lost this one. Yeah. Yep, I don't think we got this. I feel silly now. Like, I was like, yeah, we haven't seen Lance in a while. And he tends to be involved in the missions that are centered on the main plot. Like the, oh no, that's the wrong one. I want the fastest boat. Like the Diaz, and then boom, there he is, right there in a face. Oh, and unfortunately, this is a save from the Ocean View Hotel. So I had a helicopter right there before, but I won't be there now. So we'll actually have to drive back. Might be the next video starts with us actually in position to retempt that mission, and we spend the rest of this video just getting there. What this game doesn't let us do, which some later games do, I think this might start with Grand Theft Auto 4, actually, is set a destination on your map, instead of jacking a cab, like, just drive yourself, you can just actually board a cab and have the game drive you to your destination. And, you get to, I don't know why they make you pay extra to do this, it seems silly, but you can, they actually set it up so that you get to,
Hey, moving on before we're all sick.
No worries, I do, because I won't be constrained by you. Life is cheap, man.
You get to, just like fast, it's the game's version of fast travel. You get in a taxi cab, and, the taxi takes you to the destination, like, you just have to sit there and wait for it to load. Because even in Grand Theft Auto 5, where they have the entire massive map loaded up so you never have to load while you're moving around in the game yourself. When you just suddenly jump all the way across the map, there is a little bit of a load time. I think I just went to the wrong bridge, didn't I? Yep. I meant to go one further north.
Hey, can I say something? No. I'm still pissed off with you, you shoulder pad wearing shyster.
I didn't mean to listen to the NPR station that long. I'm sure that's a very droll script. I'm just like, I'd rather be listening to the music in this game. And, yeah, this might take a few tries. The boat missions are not the ones I excel at. It's fine as long as you're not turning that much. Well, that's interesting. The cop just starts running away. I don't know what these people are doing on the inside of Diaz's mansion and why he's not having his men execute them, but seems like the kind of guy who would, like, kill people who just wander in off the streets. Anyway, a little early to call it a video, but, you know, I've had several that ran long, so I'm going to call it now. And when we come back, we will be right here at the starting point to take another crack at this mission with the boat. And there's no point being coy anymore. I mean, Tommy, in his dialogue with Lance, revealed, yes, where this is going is we're going to do missions for Diaz, and eventually the plan is to betray him. But it's a nice change of pace from Grand Theft Auto 3, where you constantly get betrayed. For the most part, you get to go back and kill everyone who betrayed you. But yeah, you do missions for people, and eventually they betray you. That's Grand Theft Auto 3. Vice City, not quite as much. A little bit of that in San Andreas. But yeah, Grand Theft Auto 3, it was the pattern. So I might play that again. People seem to be responding. I mean, I'm not going crazy trying to grow my subscriber base here. This is a hobby. But yeah, my regulars, the people who tune in for things other than Romance of the Three Kingdoms and Nobunaga's Ambition do seem to be enjoying this. So I might be doing some more Grand Theft Auto in the future. Three is a possibility. But for now, let's finish this game. And we'll make more progress on that next time. See you then.